Hey friends, you know that the ability to instigate a DDoS attack is getting more and more accessible, but the technology to defend against those attacks continues to increase in sophistication. Azure DDoS Protection Standard can help protect your applications against targeted DDoS attacks. Anupam is here to show me why I should be using it for every public IP resource I own today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, it's Azure Friday. I'm Scott Hanselman. I'm here with Anupam, and we're going to talk about DDoS protection. Very important. We're always thinking about these attacks that are coming from the bad guys and how we can protect ourselves.
Absolutely. Thanks, Scott. So one of the things I want to highlight is that the frequency of the DDoS attacks continues to grow every year. And it's not only the frequency of the attacks that's growing, it's also the volume of the attacks that's growing as well. Mm. Now, it doesn't have to be like 1 terabits per second of an attack traffic to take an application down. All it needs is to be a one specific targeted attack that will impact the availability of any application running in Azure, which is receiving traffic from the public IP or the public internet.
Now, I have my applications in Azure. I think I just have front door in front of them. What kind of attack prevention do I have already? Does anything come kind of built in just because I'm in the cloud?
Right. So one thing that we actually tell all of our customers is that we should think in terms of defense in depth or zero trust. So front door offers some inherent protection against the volumetric attacks due to the scale of front door. Mm-hmm. But think about if you're deploying your backend application, which is the front door backend in a virtual network, and you're exposing that application. The example of the application could be a load balancer. It could be an application gateway. Now, that application receives traffic from the front door public IP on its own IP, which means that the public IP of that application gateway in the VNet is still exposed over the internet, and it still can be targeted with a DDoS attack. So again, the recommendation is deploy your application for acceleration with front door. The backend of the application, which is the virtual network, should be protected with DDoS Protection Standard.
Okay, so then any exposed public IP address should be protected.
That's
but
right.
What about third-party products? Like we hear about Cloudflare, and we hear about terms like this where I can put it at the DNS level and say, oh, I can just protect everything by just changing my DNS. Is that not a solution?
So it is one of the solutions, right? We have seen our customers using Cloudflare as well. Apart from our DDoS Protection Standard, the key differentiator there is that your traffic actually goes to the Cloudflare data center, and from there it gets routed into Azure.
Mm.
With DDoS Protection Standard, the traffic always remains within the Azure data center, so it also helps with the performance as well, because as we are doing the attack mitigation, the traffic never leaves the data center. We mitigate the bad traffic closest to the application, but if we do identify that the attack volume is significant, then we leverage the global scale of our Azure networking to defend the attack where it's originating.
Okay, so then given my setup where I've got about 19 or 20 Azure app services, I would put a virtual network around them. I've got front door already.
Right.
Azure DDoS protection would sit between front door and my application and protect the dotted line that I'm going to draw around my app services.
That's another way to go about it.
All right, fantastic. And show me your diagram here, because this explains exactly how this is laid out.
Right. So a couple of features that I want to highlight here is one I've already talked about, that we leverage the global scale of Azure networking, which means that anytime we are deploying the data center, we continue to grow our worldwide mitigation capacity. So DDoS service never goes down, and we have like 30 plus terabits of mitigation capacity, which means that not only we can mitigate attacks a lot more frequently, but also attacks all at the same time of significant volume. The other thing which I want to highlight here is the adaptive tuning. Now, every application's traffic pattern would be different. So in DDoS, there's a detection, and then there's a mitigation. So what we do is, using the proprietary machine learning algorithm, we understand what does the traffic pattern look like for your application, right? And based on that, we build an application traffic profile such that now we understand that 9 o'clock Monday morning, the traffic you receive on your application, on your business critical application, is very different from 9 o'clock Sunday morning. We understand how the traffic pattern changes every minute. We understand how it shifts every hour, day over day, week over week, month over month. And if we give it enough time, we'll also understand the seasonality differences.
Wow.
So now let's say that your application, your web app, receives somewhere around 30,000 packets per second. Now we will learn that, and we'll put the DDoS mitigation policy, which would be closer to that. So let's say we put it to 40,000 packets per second. Now, if someone is trying to DDoS your application, the traffic volume would surge. At that point, we'll say, something seems anomalous with the traffic. Let's start inspecting in real time whether the traffic incoming to your application is good or bad. And we'll drop the bad traffic such that it never impacts the availability and performance of your application. Now, as we are doing that, We also provide rich analytics as well as metrics through Azure Monitor and Azure Diagnostic Setting. So everything is completely integrated within the Azure system itself, and all of this is done automatically. So there's no customer configuration that needs to be put in place to do the traffic profiling. We do that automatically. Once we detect an attack, we start doing the mitigation automatically. We'll make sure that we send the notifications to Azure Security Center and through Azure Monitor. And
so you'll tell me if it happens, but if I don't even want to think about it, I can pretend and you'll just handle it for me.
Certainly, yes.
That's cool.
That's the idea. And one last thing I would like to also highlight is SLA guarantee and cost protection. SLA guarantee is straightforward. We guarantee our DDoS service will not go down, and we'll always ensure that the availability of the application is protected during the time of DDoS attack. The interesting thing is cost protection. Now, during the time of DDoS attacks, what generally happens is that the first burst of the attack can actually scale out the cost of the resources that are deployed in Azure. Mm. It could be the network bandwidth, or it could be, let's say, virtual machine scale set that grows from 10 machines to 1,000 machines. Mm-hmm. Customers who are onboarded to DDoS Protection Standard, they don't have to worry about the cost of the scale of resources. We will provide the cost credit back if that happens.
Really? So you're basically giving me DDoS insurance?
That's right.
That is actually incredibly cool. So do you have a demo? Can you actually make an attack for me?
So absolutely. So let's do this thing. So we have a product, it's from a third-party company called Ixia, where our customers can actually use this product to simulate the DDoS attack without mm-hmm. actually having to wait for an attack to happen to really understand how trained their security operations teams are.
Okay.
So here, the IP address is the IP address of my application gateway, the port is 80 on which it's listening, and I'm going to start generating the DDoS attack here. Now, as I'm doing that, real quick, what I want to show is to onboard to DDoS standard, you need to create a DDoS protection plan. Now, so all you need to do is just type DDoS here. You'll see DDoS protection plans here.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you create a DDoS protection plan, and I already have one created, when you create the plan, all you need to do there is to give a name to the plan and mm-hmm. link it to the subscription. But even though you link the plan to the subscription, it works for the entire tenant. So if you have multiple subscriptions in your tenant, you can use the same plan again and again. You don't have to go and create multiple plans.
So just one per prescription? One per subscription?
One per tenant.
Per tenant, okay.
Right. So for instance, like you can have 100 subscriptions in your tenant. You don't have to go and create multiple DDoS plan. It works cross-subscription as well as cross-region.
That's great.
So here's the plan that I have. And as you'll see that multiple subscriptions are linked to the same plan. Now the way you link it is these are the virtual networks on which we have enabled it. So what I will do is I'll navigate to the virtual network. So the first step is you create the DDoS protection plan. The next step is you navigate to the virtual network in which you have deployed your application with the public IP.
Mm-hmm.
There is a DDoS protection sublayer here. And then all you need to do is to toggle it to standard and link it to the plan that you have created.
Okay.
After that, everything is taken care of automatically in the backend. There's no custom configuration required. There's no application level changes that are required.
Really?
It's that easy to provision.
There's no control panels. Everything is done through Azure Monitor and Security Center.
That's right. Now, as we are generating the attack right now, so as you see that we are sending a lot of data, what we have done is we provide the mitigation flow logs, and all of this is also coming in like near real time, where what you see here is the log analytics report dashboard that we have created,
mm-hmm.
where the number of IPs, these are the IPs that are participating in generating a DDoS attack, right, against the application gateway. We are highlighting the statistics, which means like what's the total volume of attack traffic that's incoming and how much traffic we are dropping. In this case, 100% of the traffic is being dropped. And we also highlight from which continents, from which countries the attack traffic is actually originating, as well as why are we dropping the traffic, what attack vectors are involved. So everything that the security operations team really need to do the offline analysis, we provide all that telemetry and visibility in near real time.
Right, because there's a lot of different things. DDoS is not just simply flooding you with traffic, it's flooding you with malformed packets or starting a request and never finishing it. There's lots of things. You handle all of that.
That's right, absolutely.
Wow, that's fantastic. So do you think everyone should have this?
Everyone who has a public IP in the virtual network, which is receiving traffic from the internet on at least one port, and you care about the performance availability as well as the cost protection, you should have it. In fact, why not? And a lot of time the question comes in like, I have deployed Azure Firewall, do I need DDoS Protection Standard? Or I have deployed Web Application Firewall, do I need DDoS? These are all complementary services. Even an Azure Firewall or a WAF could be taken offline if you send a lot of traffic. So yes, that's a recommendation.
Right, and like a web application gateway might be looking at URLs for SQL injection attacks, which is different than a DDoS attack.
That's
so if you
right.
want a multi-layered strategy for security, this is one piece of that process.
Absolutely.
Very cool. So this attack is going to happen, and I can still get to your application, though.
Can you elaborate?
Like, you're in the middle of an attack.
Right.
But you said that the 100% of the packets
yes.
are being dropped. But if I visited it,
that's
not
right.
a bad guy. The application remains
available. That's the whole idea. Yes.
That's amazing. So where can I go and learn more about this? Is there a website?
So you can learn more about on the product page, which
okay.
is the Azure DDoS Protection product page. We also have like very thorough documentation, as well as the blog articles.
Fantastic. I'm going to go set up Azure DDoS Protection on my systems right now, and you should too. I'm learning all about it today on Azure Friday.